You just saw that wonderful story about Star Wars. Now I'm with Sebi. Tell me about this float here.
Well, it took us about 7 months to build it, and we, as you can see, we have what do you call it? It took us a lot of the styrofoam.
Yep.
We had styrofoam, as you can see, the dark
day. Did you guys place? Sweepstakes?
Sweepstakes, I think, yes.
Uh-huh. Did you really?
Yeah.
Now, tell me what it is. How come every guy has his thing for Star Wars? Our photographer, Dennis Quintana, saw your flow and he just about fainted.
It's about, you know, what's been happening with September 11th, and, you know, I think it's wonderful. It's, you know, what we put into, you know, a lot on it.
And what do you want to say to everybody watching?
Oh, well, I want to say hi to my family and happy Thanksgiving to everybody.
All right. And you take care. Thank Wonderful you. Flow. Isn't it just beautiful, guys? This is amazing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The Star Wars.
You like
Tina?
I think that's Darth Vader up there.
Yes,
looks like that.
Oh,
where's Darth Vader?
Michelle, I understand there's a picture on the float of 6-year-old Alex Valadez. She wanted to ride on the float, but it's all dedicated to Alex's memory.
And I believe the folks who did this are connected to some of the proud Bowie Bears. It's the Bear Connection. But the Star Wars theme and look, and yes, all men out there, there's something about Star Wars, the power of Luke Skywalker and the same thing as
old cowboy movies. It's cops and robbers, good guys against bad guys, and I think that's a lot of the appeal of Star Wars today.
Let's take a look at what Paul Zimmerman's up to. Paul.
Yeah, for some reason, these guys won't stop clowning around. What's up with that?
I don't know. You know what the deal is? We don't understand how to be adults. So you always
I can relate.
Kid. You always got to be a kid.
Anybody tell you guys dress funny?
And there we go, back to the Star Wars flow. Thank you, Paul. There are a lot of Shriners here, and they're acting up here on Montana.
Shriners are always a big part of every parade. They've got their tin Lizzies, they've got their motorcycles, the clowns, all kinds of other precision driving teams.
That's right.
And they always make...
We sure do. We enjoy having them.
And, of course, you know, that's what we see at the Shriners all the time, but they support the Burn Hospital in Galveston.
That's right.
And they help kids with, you know, orthopedic problems and burns and everything like that. So they, on the outside, we see them clowning around and having a lot of fun, but they raise money to help children who are in a great deal of need.
That's right.
We'll be back right after this break.
NBC Friday begins with an American tradition, an all-new Thanksgiving Providence.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Then, an all-new Dateline. She was running out of time. Family gave her the ultimate gift, a story of hope and Thanksgiving, the miracle of baby Bella. And on an all-new Law & Order SVU, did a child's video game drive this boy to murder?
No! Gorgon killed her.
An all-new Thanksgiving Providence, an all-new Dateline, and an all-new Law & Order SVU, NBC Friday.
This was me last summer mowing my lawn, watering my lawn, paying my water bill. This is me this spring converting my lawn into a water-smart landscape. This is what I don't want my yard to look like. This is what I do want my yard to look like. These are some of the trees and shrubs that are water-smart. These are the advantages of El Paso Water Utilities Pilot Turf Rebate Program. 50 cents for every square foot of established grass I remove. Find out for yourself. Call 594-5508. This could be your yard.
Come join us November 30th and December 1st and 2nd at Dickerson's Barn for the La Casa Bazaar. Over 200 vendors will be on hand for a one-stop shopping opportunity for holiday gifts. Visit the La Casa Bazaar at the following times. Tickets are $10 for preview night, $3 on Saturday, and $2 on Sunday. Children under 12 are free. All proceeds go directly to La Casa for victims of domestic violence and their families. For more information, call 526-2819.
News Channel 9 is keeping the spirit of America alive in the borderland and providing inspiration to our troops overseas with moving picture postcards.
You're the ages between 6 and 13, and you have a patriotic message you'd like to share. Write to the address on the screen.
All of our moving picture postcards will air on News Channel 9 and later be presented to our troops overseas as a holiday gift.
Show your spirit with a moving picture postcard.
And we're back. We were just visiting during the break with more of those Shriner clowns. They were cutting up. They were trying to come up here on top of our little cherry picker here, and they were trying to wreak havoc, but we had a good time with them. More Tin Lizzies. Ah, here we go. Rev them up. Let's go to Michelle. Michelle, behave yourself out there.
Yeah, I'm with Los Osos Orgullosos, right, Maria?
Right.
And you guys gonna play me a song here?
Yeah.
Come on, let's hit it. We're on TV, guys. El Mariachi Loco. One, two, three. Are you guys singing for me, Maria? Ready? Tell us about the mariachi band.
Buis has been known for its Osos Orgullosos, and right now we have a lot of new students, but we're
pretty good, huh? Yes. Do you get hired a lot to do funerals, weddings, stuff like that?
Well, yes.
Yeah? Yes. What's your favorite song?
The one I sing.
The what?
The one I sing.
The one you sing, which is what?
Is Si Nos Dejan.
All right. Locos del Corazón. Back to you guys. Locos del Corazón. Tan, 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 na, 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 na. Somos locos del corazón.
Somos osos de corazón.
Oh.
Somos osos.
Osos. De... That's what you... Isn't it Somos Locos?
No, Somos Osos.
Oh, okay. Back to you guys.
Michelle, it's osos, not locos. You were making them crazy. The Crazy Bears, no, they're great. They're a great mariachi group. There you see the precision of the Shrine Motor Patrol. One of the leaders is our good friend Steve Masters.
And again, there you see part of the Bowie High School Proud Bear Marching Band. 50 members in the band under the direction of Jimmy Gonzalez. Now they're, in the past, they've won the Sun Carnival Parade Spirit Winner. And in 1999, they were first division performance at the Andrus Invitational and first division performance leader at the Socorro Marching Festival as well.
And they're very, very good. For a high school mariachi, you just can't believe it. They sound so, so good. And the Osos Orgullosos, there are a number of Bowie Bear exes who participate in a number of events in our community to keep the community growing, and they're all proud graduates of Bowie High School. More Motor Patrol. There they go, the mariachi loco quiere bailar. Cantina, brought to you by the Bear Connection. This is an all Bowie offering here, and it was also a winner of the Queen's Award. And it is really a sensation.
That Star Wars Cantina, you know, we talk about El Paso being a multicultural city, and it is, but that Star Wars Cantina was kind of the ultimate in multiculturalism. They had beings from all over the universe.
That's right, all over the universe, that's right.
One of the funniest scenes in any of the Star Wars episodes.
There's Darth Vader. I see Luke Skywalker. And they're playing music.
I see C-3PO, the robot.
C-3PO, that's right.
R2-D2's got to be in there somewhere.
He's running around in there somewhere, I'm sure. And the big Darth Vader right in the center of the float. And Darth Maul in his
red. Darth Maul, that's the guy up there with the red face up there. Kind of looks like Beelzebub.
And don't forget, Star Wars fans, next summer, the prequel to the prequel, if you will. Once again, another incredibly well-done float.
Okay, what were the little bear creatures called? And I think
Chewbacca's?
No, no, Chewbacca was he was a Wookiee, right?
Wookiees.
Chewbacca was a Wookiee.
He was a Wookiee. He was like the king of the Wookiees, wasn't he? Where is Dennis Quintana when you need him?
And the little bear-like creatures, they were little teddy bears. I can't remember their names.
I can't remember their names.
But they have big ones in there.
And they dance to Barry Manilow. Who knew?
That's Darth Maul. That just looks like somebody from Roswell there.
That's right. That's right. I don't remember him in Star Wars. They're dancing a Very nice.
And right after the Star Wars float, we see some of the Bowie High School Proud Bear marching
That's
band.
That's right.
We saw the Proud Bear mariachis before the float, but after the float, we've got the Bowie High School marching band.
And their bear mascot is here too, wowing the crowds. Let's hear a little bit of their music. There. It's one of the oldest high schools in El Paso, Bowie High School. Playing the Star Wars theme.
Right?
Yes, I'm the sponsor for the Clark Cowboys. They're consisted of the 7th grade and 8th grade cheerleaders. And we won second place city champs this year.
Oh, you won second place. What's your name?
Miriam.
Oh, I like your orange strings on your bracelet.
Thank
Those
you.
Are cool. And what's your name?
Yvette.
Yvette. Do you guys watch News Channel 9 all the time?
Yes.
You want to say hi to Nick Miller and Philippa?
Hi!
Hi, Philippa! And what about Paul Zimmerman? You guys like Paul Zimmerman?
Yes.
All the girls think he's hot. They always ask for Paul Zimmerman. So you want to say hi to him? He's listening to you guys.
Hi, Paul!
We got some fans over here that want to say hi. Keep up with the good job, girls.
Okay,
back to you.
Those are the Walter Clark cheerleaders from Walter Clark Middle School. And they got a lot of pep, don't they?
That's what cheerleaders are all about.
That's right. And no one like Michelle Vias to rev them up even more.
Right behind, you've got the Old Mesilla Association stagecoach. It's a replica of an 1860 Heavy Concord stagecoach. The name Concord comes from the city of Concord, New Hampshire, where the Abbott and Downing Company built hundreds of these coaches to be shipped all over the world.
And we'll be right back here live from Montana Avenue at the 65th Annual Sun Bowl Parade. Don't miss a minute of it.
God bless America.
And God bless you, John.
Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
One more time.
We all live in the yellow submarine. Yellow
great submarine. Great song, isn't it, guys?
It's great. It's the Beatles. It's wonderful. But we're going to practice later, Michelle, okay?
It is built by the Downtown Lions Club.
That's right.
Animation includes operable propellers, a movable rudder, and fully workable periscope.
And bubbles.
Yeah, I saw bubbles coming out of the, I guess they were coming out of the periscope there, but that's another one of the great things that Lions Club has done for the parade today. They're always very involved in everything we do here on the Sun Bowl Parade.
And we have the Toys
Looks
for
like
Tots
the
Humvee.
Marine Corps Reserve Toys for Tots.
That's right, with our special friend Santa Claus on board. Can't have a parade without Santa. He's making notes to see if everyone out here is being naughty or nice. Let's take a look at Paul Zimmerman and what he's got cooking.
Yeah, I tell you what, I was digging on that Yellow Submarine float. Used to listen to the Beatles with my dad all the time as a little kid. And by the way, Michelle, I did find a Texas Longhorn fan, but he left. So anyway, we're hanging out here in this is the dog pound section of the bleachers. We got Scooby here. Is that Scooby?
There's a Scooby.
Yeah, Scooby-Dooby-Doo. And over here, a nice, pretty Chihuahua.
That lady.
All right. Boy, she looks all dressed up for Thanksgiving. How are you enjoying things? And there you have it. Another satisfied customer here at the parade. Michelle, what's up?
Paul, look who I found, Ronald McDonald.
Oh, it's so good to see you again.
What do you want to say to all the kids out there, Ronald?
Well, I want to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving. Have a great day. I'm glad to be back here in El Paso, and we've got a great time. Hey, you like jokes, right?
Yeah, I want a joke.
Why does a dog wear more clothes in the summertime than he wears in the wintertime?
I don't know.
Because in the winter, he just wears a coat, but in the summer, he wears a coat and pants.
Ba-dum-bum-bum. Come on with something better.
Hey, just really happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
All righty, have a shake.
You want a free shake?
Yeah, I want a free shake. Ready? Okay. Let's see Ronald shake. Woo-hoo! Nice free shake.
Happy Thanksgiving. I'm glad you're not afraid of me anymore.
Oh, no, no,
she
no.
She was scared when she...
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you were.
No, I wasn't.
Did you hug him, Michelle?
The what?
Did you hug
him? I already hugged you, right?
Yes, you did.
Yeah, because I have this mascot fetish going on. I don't know. I love mascots. They're just so cute.
Cute. Puppies and children, cute.
Thanks. Bye, Ronald. Okay. Back to you.
They do such good work, the Ronald McDonald House, for families of children with cancer, and we appreciate Ronald being here today, and Michelle Huggin, Ronald McDonald.
We had the All-City Cheerleaders come by a little while ago. I think we saw some of them. They were formed in 1992. The cheerleaders range in age from 6 to 17, and they were... There are cheerleaders from all over town, from different schools. Now, you know, we were planning to have a post-game, a post-parade show from 12 to 12:30, but this parade is going a little longer than we expected. There are more floats and more activities in the parade, so we're just going to keep on covering it.
I'm trying to figure out what that is, Nicholas.
That looks like a big Air Force guy. I don't know.
Is there someone actually in there?
I would imagine there is.
I guess there is. I think
unless
he's having a hard time.
Unless he's a robot.
Unless he's a robot.
He's a big Air Force recruiter.
That's right. Ready to recruit everybody.
I think there's somebody probably
board.
In there.
There's got to be.
He jumped, did the splits.
Oh, my gosh. And we've got some Boy Scout groups and bicycles, and we've got more
little Cub Scouts on the bikes.
That's right. And we've got more cheerleaders coming up. A lot of patriotic spirit here today on Montana Avenue for this parade. Red, white, and blue is everywhere. We all appreciate that unity that we're feeling today. Now Riverside High School.
There.
Now we've got the Riverside High School band is coming down, and they're marching today in loving memory of Jacqueline Rodriguez and Valerie Provencio. Two young girls whose lives were cut all too short last weekend in a car accident. They're remembering them today, this Thanksgiving Day.
One of the young ladies was a cheerleader at Riverside as well, so.
That's right.
It's always a...
We'll be right back. It's coming up on 12 noon here at the Las Palmas Parade.
It's the real deal.
I'm Dave Oxford with the Finnish
Islanders.
Army Reserve Officers Training Course.
Let's talk to Michelle Valles now.
Hi, I'm with Pixie from the Riding and Driving Club. Pixie, what did you do to your horse?
Oh, he just got painted up. Oh. Figured since I'm riding bareback that I ought to look like an Indian pony.
What's his name?
Cody.
Cody. Well, you have a great time, okay?
Thank you, and happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you. What you guys got going over there?
Oh, that horse is painted green.
It's a real painted pony.
A painted pony. And its hooves. Oh, and
the
he's such a pretty
are green.
Horse.
A little bit of green paint on the side.
Oh, here comes another fabulous float.
This is United We Stand float. Oh, this is New York.
New York.
York.
Oh, I hear crystal Frank blue unicorns, in the background, the chairman of the board.
The crystal blue unicorns dance team built this float of the New York City nighttime skyline. The float has New York sights, including Lady Liberty.
That's right.
The Statue of Liberty is made of styrofoam. It's about half the true size of the original in New York Harbor.
That's right, and they're ribbons in memory of the Twin Towers. And the girls are dressed in black tuxedos with silver top hats and canes.
I think I see the Empire State Building there, too.
That's right. Very poignant for this year to remember New York and our friends there. And no one sings it like Frank. Sadly, this year, the Blue Unicorns lost their beloved founder, Lucy Rodriguez. She did a lot to promote this group and to get these girls to perform just about everywhere. And nobody can sing it like Frank.
In tuxedos, top hats, and
canes.
That's
right. The Blue Unicorn Dance Troupe. And some of these older girls have been with the group since they're little bitty dancers. Very good. Now, after we see New York, New York, we're going to have the elite Wildcat All-Star Cheerleaders. They've only been together 9 months, so they've accomplished a lot in a short period of time. And they've already taken their first national competition. The juniors took second, the seniors took fourth. They're preparing
and they're
to
getting
go
ready
the,
now to go to the Nationals
right.
in Las Vegas.
That's right.
Under the direction of Charles Sweet Jr. and Charlene Menendez. The team motto is heart, dedication, and commitment.
And you know, along with the cheerleaders, you see a lot of sponsors and moms that walk right alongside with them. So you got to give, you got to give them a lot of credit.
This is the Justo Sierra Mendez School, primary school in Juarez. They're under the direction of Edgar Lopez. The students are from 8 to 11 years old. Fourth year they've marched in the parade.
It's referred to in Juarez as a escuela primaria, which means like your first hurdle before middle school. Let's go to Michelle Valles now.
Hi, Felipe. I'm with Mr. Bustillos from the U.S. Border Patrol. He's with the Horse Patrol. Now, tell us about this. These are horses are assigned to you guys, right?
Yes, we have a total of 15 horses assigned to our sector, and we're the unit that participates on parades and all operations also.
Do you have to take care of your own horse and everything?
Yes, we have a wrangler and agents take care of their own horses.
Everyone's getting wild up. We better go. Keep them out. This is why everyone's yelling. Oh, no. Where's the pooper scooper when you need one?
Michelle, you did it. You didn't. Okay, well, just keep walking. Keep walking. Keep a going. Atta girl. Oh, no. You need to get out some grass, Michelle.
One of the hazards of parade duty.
That's right. Parade duty is not always the neatest thing. And coming up, we couldn't be without our Border Patrol here in El Paso County and our international borders, and they're beefing up their security to make us safe here in
you
El Paso County.
The Mounted Border Patrol, and you see the men right there on their ATVs and bicycles. They use all kinds of different vehicles and horses and so forth to patrol our borders.
We thank them for their hard work and dedication. This has been just a wonderful parade this year. It's a long one, too, because they had such magnificent entries, all stories to the songs. And we saw everything from the yellow polka dot bikini
to the yellow submarine.
The yellow submarine.
How much is that doggy in the shelter?
And there was some Barry Manilow happening, some the Star Wars theme, and, you know, ending it with Frank Sinatra. You can't do better than that.
Very nice parade, 65th annual Sun Bowl Parade, and we had absolutely beautiful weather for it today. And I don't think anybody could complain about getting cold today.
No, I'm kind of in a woolly coat, and now I'm just ready to get rid of it.
A bit breezy out here, but it's been absolutely beautiful weather. So we hope you've enjoyed the 65th annual Sun Bowl Parade, and we were happy to bring it to you today.
But keep your seats. We're not over yet. It's the Sun Bowl Post-Parade Show that's coming up next, live with Michelle Valles and Paul Zimmerman. And I'll be running around here at Houston Park. catching all the excitement of what we're doing here today. We thank you so much for joining us. But once again, don't touch that dial. We've got more parade coverage to come.
Have a happy Thanksgiving, everybody. Have a wonderful day.
NBC Friday begins with an American tradition, an all-new Thanksgiving Providence.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Then, an all-new Dateline. She was running out of time, but her family gave her the ultimate gift, a story of hope and Thanksgiving, the miracle of baby Bella. And on an all-new Law & Order SVU, did a child's video game drive this boy to murder?
No! Gorgon killed her.
An all-new Thanksgiving Providence, an all-new Dateline, and an all-new Law & Order SVU, NBC Friday.
You kids want some chicken nuggets?
Hey, you're not the real Santa.
What? A phony Santa giving away mystery meat nuggets?
Not today!
Freeze, Claus! Stuff that in a stocking. Now, taste the holiday cheer of all-white meat KFC popcorn chicken.
KFC popcorn chicken is back. Crunchy on the outside, juicy on the inside. Get an individual size for just $1.99 or a party size for just $6.99.
Popcorn chicken to all and to all a good night!
News Channel 9 is keeping the spirit of America alive in the borderland and providing inspiration to our troops overseas with moving picture postcards.
You're the ages between 6 and 13, and you have a patriotic message you'd like to share. Write to the address on the screen.
All of our moving picture postcards will air on News Channel 9 and later be presented to our troops overseas as a holiday gift.
Show your spirit with a moving picture postcard.
Tickets are now on sale for the 10th annual El Paso Christmas Pageant. Call or come by Cielo Vista Church to reserve a seat for any of the 10 performances. Our ticket office is open daily. It's conveniently located in the parking lot next to the Montana entrance. Take advantage of our new drive-in convenience or place your order by phone. Just don't miss the highlight of the Christmas season, Cielo Vista's 10th annual El Paso Christmas Pageant, beginning Friday, December 7th.
After a car wreck injury, time is of the essence. Witnesses, documents, photos, and treatment may be needed right away.
Don't take chances. Call the attorneys you've known for years, Angel Reyes and Associates. Our legal team stands ready to gather the information you need to help get you the cash settlement you deserve. Call Angel Reyes and Associates now. Helping injured Texans is what we're all about. I'm Angel Reyes, and you have my word on it.
Call Angel Reyes and Associates at 881-8881.
Wednesday on News Channel 9, the FBI plans to send profilers and other experts to help find the killer of 5-year-old Alexandra Flores. And News Channel 9 reports there are almost 500 registered sex offenders in the city. More proof, we're keeping you connected here on News Channel 9.
Welcome back to Montana Street. It was a 2.7-mile stretch from Ochoa to Copia.
Yep, it looks like we need a shower and everything. Bad hair day. We had a lot going on today. Windy and lots of parades and lots to do.
That's
lots
right.
Lots of floats, I mean.
17 floats, 17 bands, some specialty units. If you missed it, no problem. This is the parade postgame show. I'm Paul Zimmerman. Some people call me the Z-Man.
This is
Michelle Vaez. And,
how you doing? Happy Thanksgiving,
I like to call her Mitch.
Yeah, everyone calls me
Mitch. Yeah, you're pretty bad on a horse. You know that?
Oh, my. That was one of the highlights. I got on a horse last year, and everyone said, oh, you're not going to do it again. And my photographer, Dennis Quintana, says, you know, that took a lot of guts because you didn't know that horse, but
Hey, I just got on the horse. Pedro let me from Canutillo, and he even did a little dance.
It takes guts, baby. Yeah.
What was your, what'd you like best about the parade?
I like skateboarding with the clown the best. That was cool. It was very hectic because the street sweeper had just come through. The street was wet. You break out a skate on that, man, you could be in trouble, you know?
But I got to tell you, the best thing about the parade today, the last interview I did with the U.S. Border Patrol, the crowd was yelling. And I was like, what are they yelling at? I thought they wanted me to keep going. Turns out that I stepped in poop, Paul. Huge lumps of it.
It looks like you got it off pretty good.
I'll be careful with you. It's still on my shoe, I think, but that's got to be a classic. Just, I'm always going to remember that.
One of the highlights of the parade. I'm wondering how Jose Solis is doing up there. He's been up there for almost 2.5 hours without a break.
Yep.
I hope my man didn't have to go to the restroom.
All our guys, huh? Richard, Dennis, Eric. Who do we got here? Chris Roth. We have a lot. Oh, we're showing some highlights here. Here's the El Paso Downtown Lions Club. They were playing We all live in a yellow submarine. Good old Beatles.
Still singing that one.
A lot of good bands today.
Yeah, the Austin High Band, I believe that is right there. What I like is the Marfa kids coming all the way down, driving 3 hours to share some music with us here on Thanksgiving Day.
It's cute. They only had like 20 band members, just to give you an idea of just how small Marfa is.
Right on.
You still made it.
Well, you've been asking everybody what they're thankful for. What are you thankful for, Michelle?
Oh, I'm just thankful that, you know, this year has gone by with a lot of blessings and no tragedies, you know, personal tragedies, great family. I have all my family here. What about you, Paul? You're from El Paso, too.
Yeah, I'm thankful to be home. I'm going to go eat turkey dinner over at Grandma's house. My brother drove into town from San Diego, so that's going to be sweet.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You going to party today?
A little bit. I think it's inevitable. I found a few people who look like they were already partying out here.
I know. What's up with that? We were working hard, but hey, it pays off.
Yeah. They're clearing out already, maybe to go check out the Cowboy game, enjoy some turkey. We'll have some more highlights. We're going to check out Sam Donaldson up close and personal, Nick Miller's interview. That's coming up.
That's after the break.
Yeah. Stick around. The post-game show rolls on.
Yellow submarine.
Now is the time to join the El Paso Zoological Society. Society members help support the El Paso Zoo's animal acquisitions, education and volunteer programs, veterinary facilities, and special events. Zoo memberships are available for individuals, families, and business. Benefits include admission to the El Paso Zoo for 1 year and discounts at the Elephant's Trunk Gift Shop. Your membership is also good for admission to over 100 other zoos and aquariums throughout the U.S. Join the Zoological Society by calling 532-8156.
Make no mistake. The message is clear. It's time for great year-end values and amazing selection. Toyotathon 02. Get the reinvented 2002 Camry. More power, more room. Sport-tuned suspension. 2002 Camry. Lease it. $299 a month for 39 months with $2,892 due at signing. At Dick Poe Toyota and Hoy Fox Toyota. Toyotathon 02. Password, value.
Your children, your family, the center of your world, and the foundation of our community. Now, News Channel 9 and Texas Tech are keeping you and your loved ones healthy and safe with a new bi-monthly segment called KTSMD. Medical updates, health tips, technological advances, valuable information to keep you and the ones you love healthy and happy. KTSMD, your connection to good health. Every other Sunday at 10 on News Channel 9.
Critics have called it strikingly original, a timeless masterpiece, and breathtaking. You will call it sensational. Trans-Siberian Orchestra's Christmas Eve and Other Stories Live, December 19th at Don Haskins Center. An evening with the most stirring and powerful blend of rock and classical music ever heard. Reserve seats at UTEP Ticket Center, all Ticketmasters by phone or online. Trans-Siberian Orchestra's Christmas Eve and Other Stories Live.
All right, welcome back to the parade. Most of the people have Yase Fuade, but Mitch and Z, we're still here. We're still hanging out. The story behind the song, the theme of this year's parade, that's whatever you want it to be.
Yeah, and there were a lot of bands this year, and the first band to come out was the 60-second Army band, and I saw a lot of tears as that band went through. A lot of people are very patriotic, very sentimental. There's certainly a familiar sight along the Montana Street every year, and this year Fort Bliss Zone's 60-second Army band was honored to be a part of it all, and we were all honored to watch.
For 226 years, the Army has had a musical tradition. And we support that musical tradition. It's a great honor. And it's also an opportunity for us to be performing musicians and not starve to death.
The more you work, the more you can get an open sound, the better the intonation.
The band field is one of the few fields in the Army where you have to know your job before you come in the Army. We primarily support all the air defense, which is kind of unique. This is the one post where they train all the air defense soldiers. Current events, you know, there's a lot more visibility and focus on the military in general, so it gives you a little bit more to think about to go out and represent the military and show people what we do out there in the community.
I've always thought it's been an honor what we do in terms of supporting the community, trying to inspire patriotism, but now it seems that there's a more receptive ear in the community, and I think it makes our job much more important, also in terms of supporting the troop morale.
I think it makes for a little more camaraderie and a good time. It's a good job to have in the military.
All righty, Paul, I have no choice. Put on this hat.
Where'd you get that?
Oh, it's a girlfriend's hat, and I borrowed it. Because last year I wore this, like, gorilla jacket, and everybody hated it, but some people loved it.
All right.
So today I had to keep with tradition. I said, I'm going to wear something funky.
Yeah, stay animal.
Really, you know, I really have to wear it because it's so windy out. So it's either have my hair all over my face or wear this cheetah hat.
Yeah, well, in case you missed it, Sam Donaldson blew through here a little bit earlier. Sam, a graduate of UTEP. I went to UTEP for journalism, so I was pretty stoked to see Sam out here.
Yeah, he's also a native of El Paso. And earlier today, our own Nick Miller, the journalism man of El Paso, got to speak with good old Sam.
Yeah, Nick and Sam.
Well, I went to a school called Dudley Grade School, and I played the drums, and I can remember in the Sun Bowl parade, our little band marched. It was a cold day, and I guess I was, what, 7 or 8, whatever it was, trying to play the drums, going up Montana Street. I'm delighted to be back, Nick, because now I get to ride instead of walk.
And it's not nearly as cold today either.
It's wonderful.
Your reflections on this Thanksgiving, it's the first major holiday since September the 11th. Just give me some of your reflections on that.
Well, I was a little kid in World War II, but I remember the spirit of the country, and I remember the unity of the country, a country under attack. And I hadn't seen that until these last 2 months. And in this Thanksgiving Day, I think, once again, the unity of the country, the resolve of the country, the sadness, of course, is still with us, is a remarkable thing. I just hadn't seen that now in, what, 60 years?
Yeah.
Long time.
All right. Hey, Sam Donaldson, you know what? You know you've made it when you get spoofed on Saturday Night Live. Are we live?
Yeah, we're live.
Yeah,
it's
it's
great.
Yeah, I tell you, I kind of think Sam looks like, who is that, Spock from Star Wars?
He's a guest here, Paul. Be nice.
I am being nice. That's a compliment. Spock's a good man. Hey, we got more coming up. Stick around.
Big dreams, big moments. Celebrate with your favorite friends.
I'm getting married today!
What? There's wild romance.
Come on, Ross, let's go have sex.
And big events you won't want to miss.
We're going to see each other naked.
Excellent. The best times are with friends.
Yeah, baby.
Hi, El Paso. Thanks for watching News Channel 9 and for supporting great events like Maggie's Tournament. All right.
Today, a child will discover her gift. A teacher will hear his calling. A grandmother will find hope. And Sparky will get the home he's been dreaming of. Every day in every way, the people of News Channel 9 are working for you, supporting community events and organizations that give back and make the borderland a better place to live. Shedding light on issues that are close to your heart is a big part of what we do, because your life is more than headlines.
Meet the lady who's destined to be the next leader in talk. Meet Ananda Lewis.
It's like day ready. I hope you guys are. We are talking about all kinds of things today, like being accepted, fitting in, being beautiful.
We're going to be a fun, curious, candid, honest is the biggest word I've always felt in my heart. Finally giving your people and your towns and community something they can feel good about watching.
This is big. Go big, big.
We are talking to you.
I life of myself. Yeah.
That's big. Ding, 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 ding. Is this the show for you? It's a revolution of the spirit.
I didn't know that's what it was, but we're having one.
Weekdays at 4 on News Channel 9.
All right, we are giving muchas gracias on this Thanksgiving Day. Welcome back to the post-parade show. Z-Man and Mitch checking out beautiful Mount Franklin in the background.
Yeah, we would be nothing without those towers, right?
Yeah.
We're thankful for
those. That's true.
Towers.
I'm very thankful for those
and
things out
again,
there.
I'm wearing my hat because it's so windy out here. And you were talking about the Marfa High School band. About 20 of them came down.
That's right.
It takes a lot for a three-hour drive.
That's right.
And then they still have to make it back for Thanksgiving dinner.
Yeah, turkey on the table for those guys coming up. We have right coming up here a little story about what the Marfa kids are all about.
Hello, my name is George Mingil. I'm the band director at Marfa High School, where the mascot is the Shorthorn. And we are from Marfa, Texas, population 2,500. We knew the El Paso Parade had been performed at in the past, in the late 70s and in the 80s. And so we wanted to return to that. We're really excited to be there. And we've done other parades, so we're kind of conditioned to it right now. These kids are probably some of the best kids I've ever worked with. Definitely, definitely good kids, willing to work, very spirited about their school. And the whole community is just very supportive of the school and everything that happens. We will only be marching about 35, though. We're really excited to be there.
And that story was brought to us by Chris Rodriguez.
Yeah, Chris Rod, the man.
Now we're in the sun, Z-Man. That way we can, you know, get a little sun
like
and wind
better
at the same time.
Yeah, it's a little chilly over here in the shade. Breezy, you know, fans cheering for snow earlier in this parade.
And I didn't ask you what... Oh, I did. What are you thankful about?
Thankful just to be here, baby.
To be back in El Paso.
Yeah. Thankful to be here. It's a lot of fun. Phoenix was cool, but it was hot.
Oh, it's
too hot.
Mad hot.
Thought it was
like
gonna melt.
Yeah. Well, we got some more highlights coming up. We're gonna try and bring you some in case you missed the parade. We're gonna bring you all those highlights. Paul talking to all the people. Oh, a very patriotic parade. Mother and child, American flag.
Yeah.
Oh, that was an awesome float. Paying tribute to the people of New York. And those little girls were dancing.
That's...
Dun, 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 dun.
I like that. I'm glad we're doing this because I missed this float, actually.
Nothing like Frank Sinatra.
I'm leaving today.
And I believe the face of the Statue of Liberty is... The back of the float.
Yeah, there was some serious float competition going on, but I think everybody who entered a float in this year's competition was a winner. What do you think?
Oh, yeah. Which one was your favorite?
I was digging on Star Wars and the Yellow Submarine quite a bit.
Oh, yeah, the Yellow Submarine. I like that one. That was my favorite.
All right.
Well, we're going to take a break. Well, we're going to show you some more highlights.
We're not. We're hitting you with a quickness. Moss highlights.
Check out some more highlights. Oh, look, can you do that? You can skate, Paul.
I could do that back. I was actually a high school gymnast back at Eastwood High School. If I stretched out pretty good, I might be able to do that.
Let's see, who did we have here?
Drummers Drumming.
Drummers Drummer. I think they're from Juarez.
All right.
Well, speaking of that Star Wars float, we actually did a story on the preparations it took for that float. I think it's one of a sweepstakes winners. So.
That's right. A lot of time and hard work goes into these things.
Check it out.
The float is called Star Wars Copa. And it's based on the song called Star Wars Cantina. The episode is from the cantina scene, the bar scene of the original movie Star Wars. And, we softened it a little because it is representing the school, so we changed it to Star Wars Copa. We have approximately 23 people here pretty much every night, and most members are Bowie alumni, though there are some here who are from El Paso High School. 2 years ago, we really enjoyed doing it. We got the General's Award for Best Presentation of a Theme. We started back in May, in the summer. We didn't have a warehouse, so we had it out in Anthony. Tremendous. We had a lot of people who came on here and supported us.
Howdy, howdy. We're back, and we have more highlights to look at from this year's 65th Las Palmas Sun Bowl Parade. Street getting sweeped, people packing out. That's a live shot.
Now they got to put the turkey in the oven if they haven't done it already.
Yeah, if you haven't done it already, you're probably going to be eating about midnight, I would think.
Or go to Luby's. Right?
Yeah, that's always the quick alternative. I've always worked on Thanksgiving Day throughout the afternoon, so it's going to be a nice treat to actually be able to sit at the family
dinner
table.
Actually, the guys who are working, all the police officers and firefighters, we need to thank them, too. Uh-oh, they want me to... This is the famous highlight, Paul, that I was talking about.
Oh, yeah.
Here I am acting cool with this Border Patrol agent. Yeah, la-di-da-di. What do you guys do with your horse?
You're pretty good at that, like weaseling your way into situations.
Everybody's so nice. And he was telling me, and everybody was yelling right here. And I'm like, what are you yelling at? And I'm like, okay, keep moving because people are getting upset, right? And turns out the reason they were yelling, right here. Oh, Wakala. That's why they were yelling. They were trying to tell Michelle. We were telling you not to step in. Poop. All right, now we're going to check out some charos.
Charos. They're rad. We're out of here.
See you later.
En el jaripeo hay.
Number one, what is your name?
My name is Graham Sale, and baby.